Welcome to free online classes of physics with Lambert sir. So dear students, in the last lecture we have started the discussion for our 10th chapter electrostatics, and we understand the meaning of electrostatics. After that we studied about the frictional electricity, and we explained different examples which are explaining frictional electricity, and we studied the concept of electric charge, types of charges, positive charge and negative charge, and also we understand the two charging processes, concept of charging by conduction and concept of charging by induction. So as we have studied the concept of electric charge, here we will discuss the basic properties of electric charge. So we know that any matter possesses mass. So mass is the fundamental property of matter. And we know that matter is made up of atoms. And atoms consist elementary particles like protons, neutrons, electrons. Out of that, protons are positively charged particles, electrons are negatively charged particles, and neutrons are the neutral. So the charge of atom is from the proton and electron. That's why matter possesses charge due to the elementary particles like protons and electrons. So we can say that like mass, as mass is fundamental property of matter, charge also fundamental property of matter. See here, like mass, charge is also fundamental property of the matter. So mass is a scalar quantity, charge is also scalar quantity, possesses only magnitude. So we can define electric charge. So during the discussing regarding the frictional electricity, we come to know that when two suitable objects are rubbed against each other, they acquire or they exhibit the property of attracting light objects like pieces of papers, and that objects are said to be electrified or charged, and that property acquired by that object when they are rubbed against suitable object, that property is called as electric charge. And that electric charge is fundamental property of the matter. So electric charge can be defined like this: the property acquired by the material body when it is rubbed with another body is called as electric charge. As we have explained by giving the example of glass rod rubbed with silk cloth, that time glass rod acquires positive charge and silk cloth acquires negative charge. Both are electrified, both are charged. And that property acquired by glass rod as well as silk cloth by rubbing against each other, that property is called as electric charge. Now we will try to understand the meaning of electronic charge or fundamental charge. So, electric charge or fundamental charge of any matter or any body is what? This is the smallest quantity of electricity or electric charge that can be produced by any practical means. So, smallest quantity of electric charge is the electronic charge or fundamental charge, which can be produced by any practical means. So the meaning or definition of electronic charge: smallest quantity of electricity, you can say electric charge, that can be produced by or obtained by any practical means is called electronic charge or fundamental charge. And such smallest quantity of electric charge is denoted by the letter E. It is denoted by letter E. And this smallest quantity of charge is present on proton. Also, it is present on electron. So, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज और फंडामेंटल चार्ज इज चार्ज ऑन प्रोटॉन और एंड चार्ज ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड इट्स वैल्यू इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड इज गिवन बाय ई इक्वल टू 1.6 इंटू 10^-19 कूलम. सो दिस इज द स्मॉलेस्ट क्वांटिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज और इलेक्ट्रिसिटी दैट कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड बाय एनी प्रैक्टिकल मीन्स विच इज नथिंग बट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज और फंडामेंटल चार्ज. सो इन दिस वे वी डिस्कस द बेसिक मीनिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज. नाउ हियर वी आर डिस्कसिंग बेसिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज. सो देर आर फोर बेसिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज. सो वी नो दैट इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स, पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड नेगेटिव चार्ज. एंड इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज इज वॉट द प्रॉपर्टी एक्वायर्ड बाय मटीरियल बॉडी वेन इट इज रब्ड अगेंस्ट अनदर बॉडी. द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अट्रैक्टिंग लाइट ऑब्जेक्ट्स एक्वायर्ड बाय मटीरियल बॉडी वेन इट इज रब्ड विथ अनदर बॉडी. दैट प्रॉपर्टी इज कॉल्ड एज इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज. एंड दिस इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज पजेस फोर बेसिक प्रॉपर्टीज. फर्स्ट वन इज additive nature of that electric charge. Second basic property is quantization of charge, means charge has discrete nature. Third one is conservative property of charge. And fourth one is the forces between electric charges. So we want to explain these basic properties one by one. So let us begin with additive nature of electric charge. So this is first basic property of electric charge. As we know that electric charge is a scalar quantity and scalar possess only magnitude. That's why electric charge is additive similar to mass. As mass is scalar, it can be added. It can be added by taking its magnitude only. That's why charge is also scalar, it can be added by taking its magnitude only. So we can here say that electric charge is additive, similar to mass. The total electric charge on an object. Objects are total electric charge aplela find out karaycha asel. Is equal to the algebraic sum of all electric charges distributed on different parts of that object. So if we consider example of glass rod, the total charge on that glass rod is equal to algebraic sum of all electric charges distributed on different parts of that glass rod. Then we will get total charge on glass rod. Any object, any substance, its total charge is equal to algebraic sum of all the electric charges which are distributed on different parts of that object. So in this way, just we have to add all the electric charges and to get total electric charge on that object. So here, while taking the algebraic sum of electric charges, the signs of that electric charges must be taken into account. Whether their charges are positive, whether their charges are negative, we should take the signs of electric charges, positive or negative sign of electric charges must be taken into account. So just we have to add the charges by taking account their signs. We will explain this one example. If two bodies have equal and opposite charges, example, glass rod rubbed with silk. Glass rod loses charges, silk gains electrons. Glass rod loses electrons, that's why it acquires positive charge. And silk gains electrons, that's why it acquires negative charge. These are the two bodies. If the two bodies have equal and opposite charges, charges on glass rod and silk are equal in magnitude but opposite in nature. Then नेट चार्ज ऑन द सिस्टम ऑफ ग्लास रॉड एंड सिल्क जीरो. नेट चार्ज ऑन द सिस्टम ऑफ ग्लास रॉड एंड सिल्क जीरो. व्हाई इट इज जीरो? बिकॉज ग्लास रॉड हैज पॉजिटिव इक्वल चार्ज, सिल्क हैज निगेटिव इक्वल चार्ज. जस्ट वी हैव टू मेक द एडिशन ऑफ दैट पॉजिटिव एंड निगेटिव इक्वल चार्जेस बाय टेकिंग देयर पॉजिटिव एंड निगेटिव साइंस. दैट्स व्हाई नेट चार्ज ऑन द सिस्टम ऑफ ग्लास रॉड एंड सिल्क बिकम्स इक्वल टू जीरो. दिस इज द वे टू एड द इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस. So we can say that definitely electric charges are additive in nature. They can be simply added, just we are adding the masses of the particles of the object. But only difference is that while adding electric charges, we must take into account the charges on that electric charges. The signs, positive or negative signs of that electric charges must be taken into account. So this example, which is explaining two bodies having equal and opposite charges, net charge on the system of the two bodies is zero. This is similar to that in case of atoms. We know that in atoms, atomic nucleus is positively charged and surrounding electrons are negatively charged. The total positive charge on nucleus and total negative charge on electrons are equal in magnitude but opposite. That's why net charge of an atom becomes equal to zero. So we can say that atoms are electrically neutral. So this is similar to that in case of atoms, where the nucleus is positively charged and this charge is equal to the negative charge of the electrons, making the atoms electrically neutral. So in this way, we can say that electric charges are additive in nature, but while taking their algebraic sum, positive and negative signs of electric charges must be considered. Now we will study here similarity between additive property of charge with that of mass, because we know that mass can be added. Similarly, charges, electric charges, can be added. So what is analogy, what is similarity between the additive property of charge and mass? There are two points which are explaining analogy between additive property of charge and that of the mass. See here, the masses of the particles constituting an object. म्हणजे जो ऑब्जेक्ट पार्टिकल्स पासून बनलेला आहे त्या पार्टिकलची मासेस आर ऑलवेज पॉझिटिव. म्हणजे मास ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज ऑलवेज पॉझिटिव. Whereas the charges distributed on different parts of the object may be positive or negative. I will give you one example. We take here glass rod and silk cloth, two different bodies. Here the mass of glass rod is the masses of the particles of that glass rod, and that masses of the particles of that glass rod is always positive. But charge on glass rod is positive, while charge on silk cloth is negative. So while adding the charges, the sign of that charges should be considered, maybe positive sign or negative sign. That's why the charges distributed on different parts of the object may be positive charge or negative charge, but masses of the particles from which body is made are always positive. So mass is always positive. So additive property of mass explains that mass of an object is always positive, while additive property of charge explains that charges distributed on different parts of the object may be positive or negative. The total mass of an object is always positive, just we have explained. Object's total mass, the particle pa ja particle pasun to object banla hai, tya object's total mass he always positive mein. Whereas the total charge on the object, total charge which is distributed at different parts of that object may be zero, positive or negative. To explain this, we will consider glass rod rubbed with silk cloth. So when glass rod is rubbed with silk cloth, electrons are transferred from glass rod to silk cloth. That's why glass rod becomes positively charged and silk cloth becomes negatively charged. So total charge on glass rod is positive, as mentioned here. Total charge on silk cloth is negative. But if we consider system of glass rod and silk cloth, then total charge of the system of glass rod and silk cloth will become equal to zero. That's why total charge on the object may be zero, positive or negative, but total mass of an object is always positive. So these are the two points which are explaining analogy between additive property of charge with that of mass. So this was the explanation regarding first basic property of electric charge, which is additive nature. So let us discuss the second additive property, which explains quantization of charge, means discrete nature of electric charge. As we know that any matter is made up of atoms, and in atoms, charged particles, elementary charged particles, are protons and electrons. So protons and electrons are the charged particles constituting an matter. कोणत्याही matter मध्ये जी charged particles आहेत ती protons positively charged particles and electrons are negatively charged particles. So from these two charged particles a matter is made. Hence charge on an object, ऑब्जेक्ट वरचा जो चार्ज आहे मस्ट बी एन इंटीग्रल मल्टीपल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज, बिकॉज चार्ज ऑन प्रोटॉन और चार्ज ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉन इज इक्वल टू द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज एंड प्रोटॉन्स एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर द चार्ज पार्टिकल्स इन द मैटर. दैट्स वाय चार्ज ऑन एन ऑब्जेक्ट, कोणत्याही ऑब्जेक्ट वरचा चार्ज हा इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्जच्या इंटीग्रल मल्टीपल्स मध्ये असणार. दॅट इज चार्ज ऑन एनी बॉडी वी कॅन राईट इक्वल टू इंटीग्रल मल्टीपल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज. मग तो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज प्रोटॉन्स म्हणाला असेल, त्याचबरोबर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स म्हणाला असेल. दॅट्स वाय वी कॅन राईट हियर चार्ज ऑन एनी बॉडी, दॅट इज क्यू, दिस इज द टोटल चार्ज ऑन अ बॉडी, is equal to integral multiple of that electronic charge, plus sign for protons and minus sign for electrons. And here E is the electronic charge which is present on proton and electron. So in this equation, which is giving the total charge on any body, N is nothing but integral multiple, integer, and that N takes the values 1, 2, 3, etc., which is integer. It means that the fractional or decimal values of N is not allowed. Means electronic charge does not exist fractional value or decimal value. Only integral values are allowed for the electronic charge. That's why we can say that charge on an object is always integral multiple of electronic charge. म्हणजे एखाद्या ऑब्जेक्टवरचा चार्ज हा 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन असेल, 2 इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज असेल, 3 इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज असेल, 4 इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज असेल, बट दिस चार्ज कॅनॉट बी 0.5 इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज, 1.5 इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज, 2.5 इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज. मीन्स फ्रॅक्शनल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज डज नॉट एक्झिस्ट, डज नॉट अलाउ. ओनली integral multiple of electronic charges are present on any body. And this electric charge, we know that is a scalar quantity. Electric charge is a scalar quantity. Then charge on any object can be increased if you want to increase the charge on any object, or if we want to decrease the charge on any object. This charge increase or charge decrease will take place integral multiple of electronic charge. Not fractional charge will be increased, fractional charge will be decreased. The charge on object can be increased or decreased in multiples of electronic charge. So 1 electronic charge, 2 electronic charge, 3 electronic charge can be increased or decreased. That's why charge on electronic object, charge on any object can be increased or decreased in multiples of E. E means electronic charge, which is the smallest quantity of electric charge. So in the multiple of this electronic charge, we can increase the charge on any object or decrease the charge on any object. Now, it is because during the charging process, that means if we want to increase the charge on an object, during the charging process, an integral number of electrons can be transferred from one body to other body. So when we are rubbing glass rod against silk cloth, there is a transfer of electrons from glass rod to electrons. And the number of electrons which are transferring from glass rod to silk cloth is integral multiple of electronic charge. That means plus minus Ne, that will be the number of electrons which are transferred from glass rod to silk cloth. So this is how the number of electrons or number of electrons which are transferred from one body to other body, which is integral multiple of electronic charge. So this explains quantization nature of charge or discrete nature of charge. So this is known as quantization of charge or discrete nature of charge. In simple way, we can say that charge on body is always integral multiple of electronic charge. Charge on body does not exist in fractional value, decimal value. मध्ये कुठल्याही बॉडीवरचा चार्ज एक्झिस्ट असत नाही. And this is nothing but quantization of charge or discrete nature of charge. So this was the second basic property of electric charge. We will explain here. Quantization of charge is not observed practically. Though the charge has quantization nature, discrete nature, but practically it is not observed. We will try to find the reason behind this. See here. Quantization of charge is not observed practically. But we know that charges are always quantized. Charges are having discrete nature. When there is a transfer of electrons from one body to another body, the electrons will be transferred in multiple of electronic charge, which explains charges are always quantized. The charges are discrete in nature. But practically, this quantization of charge is not observed. We will try to explain why it is so. The magnitude of the elementary electric charge is extremely small. म्हणजे elementary particles वर म्हणजे protons असेल किंवा electrons असेल त्यांच्यावरच्या charge ची magnitude जी आहे ती extremely small आहे. यापैकी electrons are transferring from one body to another body. आणि एक electron जर transfer झाला तर चार्ज जो ट्रान्सफर होतोय तो 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 कुलम इतका चार्ज ट्रान्सफर्स फ्रॉम वन बॉडी टू अनदर बॉडी व्हिच इज एक्सट्रीमली स्मॉल. सो द स्टेटमेंट इज रिटन हियर, द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द इलेमेंटरी इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज इज एक्सट्रीमली स्मॉल. दिस इज द ऑर्डर ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ इलेमेंटरी इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज. ड्यू टू दिस, as the magnitude of elementary electric charge is extremely small, due to this, the number of elementary charges, that means electrons, the number of elementary charges involved in charging an object becomes extremely large. Because during the charging process, there is a transfer of electrons from one body to another body. So the number of elementary charges involved in charging process of an object becomes extremely large. So when we rough one object against another suitable object, that time during the charging of that object, the number of that elementary charges involved becomes extremely large. And this we can explain by taking one example. See here. For example, when a glass rod is rubbed with silk, glass rod upon silk barobar javela rub karu, then a charge of the order of 1 microcoulomb, which is nothing but 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb, appears on the glass rod or silk. The magnitude of charge on glass rod will be positive and silk the charge will be negative. So the charge on glass rod or silk Q equal to integral multiple of the electronic charge, which is equal to 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. So this is the charge which is appearing on the glass rod or silk when they are rubbed against each other. So this charge appears on the glass rod or silk due to transfer of elementary electric charges. And we want to find what is the number of that elementary electric charges are transferred from glass rod to silk. See here. Since elementary charge is extremely small, E equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb, then the number of elementary charges on the glass rod or silk we can find from this formula. Number of elementary charges, that means N we want to find, which is equal to Q upon E. See here, N that is equal to Q upon E gives us the number of elementary charges which is transferred from glass rod to silk. And if we take the value charge appears on glass rod divided by electronic charge, we get the number of elementary charges on the glass rod, how much, or silk, how much? 6.25 into 10 raised to 12. And this number of elementary charges which are present on the glass rod tremendously large. Since this number of elementary charge particles is tremendously large, quantization of charge is not observed. Because the number of elementary charges which are present on glass rod is this. This is the number. And due to that very large number of elementary charges, quantization of charge is not observed. Then one usually observes a continuous distribution of charge. Manje practically electric charge continuously distribution madhe ahe asa observe hoto. But this electric charge possesses the nature of quantization or discrete nature, but practically it does not observe because transfer of that elementary charges are very large in number, like this 6.25 into 10 raised to 12. And due to that very large number of elementary charges present on the glass rod, the quantization of charge is not observed on the glass rod. Then what is observed? One usually observes a continuous distribution of charge. So this is how we can explain the second basic property of the electric charge, which is quantization of charge. Now let us shift towards third basic property, which is conservation of charge. So in this property, we will learn one law of conservation of charge. Law or principle, we can say. Principle of conservation of charge. And its statement is like this. In any physical process, in any given physical process, electric charge may get transferred from one part of a system to other part of the system. But the total charge of an isolated system always remains constant. We will explain this by taking one example. We have large number of physical processes. We can take a rubbing of glass rod with a silk cloth, rubbing of ebonite rod with fur, rubbing of amber with wool, rubbing of rubber comb, or you can say a rubber comb when it is run fast through dry hair. All these are nothing but the physical processes. And in any given physical process, that is rubbing of glass rod with the silk cloth, what is happening? Electric charge may get transferred from one part of system to other part of the system. Electric charges will be transferred from one part of system to another part of system. But total charge of an isolated system always remains constant. We will explain this law by taking one example. But before that, we will go through the another statement of this law. See here. For an isolated system, total charge cannot be created nor be destroyed. Only that charge is transferred from one part of system to other part of the system. But total charge cannot be created nor be destroyed. So we can explain this law by taking one example. See here. And for this example, we will take the pair of glass rod and silk cloth. When that glass rod is rubbed with silk cloth, rod becomes positively charged and silk becomes negatively charged. But before rubbing, glass rod is uncharged. Silk cloth is also uncharged. Means glass rod is electrically neutral, silk cloth is electrically neutral before rubbing. Means in this case, the system of two bodies are there. before rubbing, the total charge of that system is zero. But when we rub that glass rod with silk, rod becomes positively charged and the silk becomes negatively charged. Both rod and silk acquires the charges. Here, amount of positive charge on glass rod is found to be exactly same as negative charge on silk. Means magnitude of charge on glass rod and magnitude of charge on silk are equal. Due to that, what will happen? The system of glass rod and silk together possess zero net charge after rubbing. Before rubbing, the system of glass rod and silk has also zero net charge. After rubbing, individual glass rod positive charge, individual silk cloth negative charge of equal magnitude. And if we take total charge of the system of glass rod and silk together, then we get zero net charge after rubbing. So in this case, what is happening? Before rubbing, total charge of the system is zero. After rubbing, total charge of that system is also zero. So there is a transfer of charge from glass rod to silk, but total charge of an isolated system always remains constant. So this example explains clearly the law of conservation of charge as per this statement. What is that? In any given physical process, the process of rubbing of glass rod with silk, electric charge may get transferred from one part of system to other part of system. Electric charge is transferring from glass rod to silk, but the total charge of an isolated system always remains constant. Second statement is what? For an isolated system, total charge cannot be created nor be destroyed. There is no creation or destroy of charge. Only charge is transferring from glass rod to silk. So this is how. Thus, there is mere redistribution of charge between the glass rod and silk. No new charge is created, nor is any charge is destroyed. There is mere redistribution of charge, transfer of charge. No new charge is created, nor in any charge is destroyed. Thus, the law of conservation of charge is obeyed here. In case of rubbing of glass rod with silk, the law of conservation of charge is obeyed. That is, the total charge of the system of two bodies is always conserved. Before rubbing, the total charge was zero. After rubbing, the total charge is also zero. That is, the total charge of the system of two bodies means glass rod and silk cloth, is always conserved. So in this way, we can explain the law of conservation of charge by taking this example. This law can also be explained by one example. This law can be also explained by an example, but before that, we go through this statement. This law or this principle of conservation of charge is applicable universally. Means what? In the universe, any physical process may take place in which transfer of charge may take place. And during the transfer of charge, definitely there is a law of conservation of charge is obeyed. That's why this law is applicable for universally physical processes. Now, we can explain this conservation of charge by taking one more example. So examples of conservation of charges. And to explain the conservation of charges, we will consider here the combination of electron and positron. See here. When an electron of charge minus E and positron of charge plus E are brought close to each other, what happens? They annihilate each other to produce chargeless particle called photon, or you can say gamma. So charge on electron is minus E, charge on positron is plus E. Before they are coming close to each other, what is total charge of positron and electron? Total charge on positron and electron will become zero, because minus E and this plus E becomes zero. So before the electron and positron coming close to each other, their total charge is zero. And when they brought close to each other, the charges are annihilate each other. Electron and positron annihilate each other to produce chargeless particle. So after combining electrons and positron, we are getting chargeless particle. म्हणजे त्या चार्जलेस पार्टिकल वरचा चार्ज तुम्हाला झिरो मिळाला. सो आफ्टर कंबाइनिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन अँड पॉझिट्रॉन वी आर गेटिंग झिरो चार्ज, अँड बिफोर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑल्सो झिरो चार्ज इज देअर. दॅट्स वाय देर इज अ कॉन्झर्वेशन ऑफ लॉ ऑफ चार्ज. सो लॉ ऑफ कॉन्झर्वेशन ऑफ चार्ज इज ओबेड इन दिस एक्झाम्पल. वी विल टेक सेकंड एक्झाम्पल of the radioactive decay. In radioactive decay, here we will take example of uranium nucleus, and that uranium nucleus is transferred to thorium nucleus by emitting one helium nuclei or alpha particle. So uranium nucleus is transformed to thorium nucleus by emitting helium nuclei, that is alpha particle. We can write this process like this. So this is the decay process in which uranium decays to thorium by emitting alpha particle. So in this decay process, before decay, total charge is 92 electronic charge, and after decay, the charge on thorium is 90 electronic charge and charge on helium is 2 electronic charge. Thus, the net charge before decay, 92 electronic charge, is equal to the net charge after decay, which is also equal to 92 electronic charge. So, this example clearly explains what explains. The law of conservation of charge is obeyed in this radioactive decay. So this was the second example explaining conservation of charges. Now let us learn regarding the fourth basic property of electric charge. Which one? Forces between electric charges. So we know that electric charges are of two types, positive charge and negative charge. And we also studied one conclusion in the last lecture. What is that? Like charges repelling each other. Means force of repulsion exists between two like charges, and force of attraction exists between two unlike charges. So electric charges, when there are two electric charges, they interact with each other by exerting force of attraction or force of repulsion. So these are the forces between the electric charges. Unlike charges attracts each other, means there is a force of attraction between unlike charges, while like charges repels each other, that is their force of repulsion between two like charges. And the forces between these electric charges, the force of attraction or force of repulsion between the two electric charges, is given by one famous law, which was proposed by Sir Augustine de Coulomb. So in the next lecture, we will learn the Coulomb's law in electrostatics, which explains the fourth basic property of electric charges, forces between electric charges. And that forces between electric charges are attractive forces or repulsive forces. And that forces are given by Coulomb's law in electrostatics. That we will study in the next lecture. Now, we are ending this lecture here.